So I'm the Vice President of Women's Programs and Diversity for World Out Games Miami. And in that role, the impact that I serve in the community is to connect people through different platforms of sports, culture, and human rights. The main goal is to accomplish equality.
I'm the principal of Coral Gables Preparatory Academy, and I work closely with children, parents, families, the entire community to help groom and grow the future leaders of this community.
Some of my most impactful efforts has been mentoring throughout my career. I've mentored several young women and some men regarding having a positive attitude, instilling in them their own self-worth, and that to me has been a great gift.
Well, I hope throughout my life that I've made a big difference and a positive impact in my community. I've been involved in nonprofits and volunteering ever since high school, and probably the greatest thing that happened to me is becoming the executive director of the Coconut Grove Chamber of Commerce, and through that, it launched my career in working with nonprofits.
I serve as the vice chair for the AXA Foundation for Women, and in that role, I've been a leader in the organization, involved for many years, accomplishing programs such as the Scholars Program, which enables young LGBT women to accomplish their education goals through the program. We also have a mentorship program.
Well, I was a former Girl Scout, and I was very honored many years ago to have been asked to be on the chair, to be on the board of the Girl Scout Council of Tropical Florida. Because I was a former Girl Scout, I started an alumni task force and worked with the leadership to recruit. And my big ask was to ask women of our community that had been former Girl Scouts to come and help us mentor girls, be role models, be guest speakers, so that the girls could see how they could connect the dots and how they could also be where they wanted to go with careers and empower themselves with a great future.
When I first got to the Women's Fund, we had awarded a grant to an organization called the Mustard Seed through Sir Optimus, and it was $1,250, and the project was to buy dirt and seed for women to do organic gardening through Agape, which is a transitional center for women coming out of jail. With that money, they were able to cultivate and create an environment where women learn how to garden and how to care for something.
I had the pleasure of working with the YWCA of Greater Miami, and I worked with all of their programs, which is dedicated to improving the lives of women and children. It was a great experience. I met a lot of wonderful women, both people who work there as well as the people that we helped. Probably my greatest accomplishment there was working with the Rosie O'Donnell Foundation, the Health Foundation of South Florida, and the University of Miami to establish a learning center for young children, actually from birth to 5 years old, called Opening Windows of Opportunity Early Learning Center.
I'm on the board of Global Ties Miami, and the benefit to this organization for the community is the fact that it builds bridges to the global community. So we have programs for business leadership or community understanding, which fosters empathy and awareness of other cultures, and these programs are organized through the U.S. State Department.
This year, I was asked to chair the Business and Education Community for the Coral Gables Chamber. It's a great honor, and I consider myself here to help all of the schools and all the businesses within the community form a bridge so that we can get the community into the schools. One of my programs that I'm trying to kick off right now is Readers Are Leaders, and also a mentorship program.
The one organization that I really, that I work for now is the Women's Fund in Miami-Dade County. And as the executive director and part of that organization. I'm very blessed because this past year we actually gave out grants to 31 different organizations. We also have 3 collaborations with women's organizations in Miami-Dade County. One is the Girls Coalition, which is girl organizations. They meet once a month and they share knowledge and they learn about other opportunities to collaborate. We also have the Freedom of Violence collaboration that meets once a month. Again, organizations that are working in Miami-Dade County on domestic violence, sex trafficking, other forms of violence against women and girls.
Well, I have to say the organization that I am currently the director of is the one I'm most involved with. It's called Reserve South Florida, and we work with people 55 and older who leverage their professional expertise and skills for social good. We work with nonprofits and public institutions, and we provide help to them to help them keep on mission.
The woman in my life that inspired me, she's no longer here since she died of lung cancer in 2008, but she was my mother and I learned a lot from her. She was born in 1934 during the Great Depression, and I think because she experienced financial hardship, being from an agricultural background, the values that she instilled in me was the value of perseverance and also resilience.
My mom is my greatest role model and my mentor. She is no longer here with me, but she's my biggest guardian angel. She's always inspired me and had everything to do with all of my successes. She came here as a refugee to this country, worked very hard, went to school, obtained her master's degree while working full-time and raising her family. There is nothing that I can't do because my mom has instilled in me those qualities of perseverance, setting goals, and doing what's right and working very hard.
My sister, she was born with a disability. And she also had a very difficult childhood due to a criminal act against her. And she's an amazing woman. Along with my mother.
Well, many women have inspired me, but I have to say probably the first two women were my mom and my grandmom. They taught me to derive solace in nature and love and appreciate the bounty of a beautiful, well-kept garden. And they were very generous. They always had a seat at the table for someone less fortunate. In fact, oftentimes they didn't eat so that somebody else could.
Decided to join the United States Navy, and as a result, I was able to gain an education. I earned a master's degree in behavioral psychology, and the world just opened up to me in terms of opportunity and really learning was that what was outside of my own reality.
Well, my biggest accomplishment is being a mom of 2 amazing kids and having them be college graduates today. But professionally, it's expanding Coral Gables Elementary that I became principal of in 2003 and creating Coral Gables Preparatory Academy with 2 campuses on 2 separate locations.
One of the most important accomplishments I was able to achieve was I was a stay-at-home mom. I was president of the PTA. My children, I was very young. I had children very young. I think I was 26.
I've been proud of all the things that I've, all the organizations that I've worked with and all the things that I've done. As the first executive director and woman executive director of the Coconut Grove Chamber of Commerce, I was involved in so many great things, including the Miami Film Festival, the 11 Mile Party, which was the launch of Metrorail. Think how long ago that was, but there I was planning that. And I was also involved with the inauguration of the Bass Museum of Art. It had been closed for 5 years, and I finished their capital campaign and opened the doors, as well as the grand opening of Shake-A-Lake. And now I'm involved with Reserve South Florida, and I've worked with hundreds of nonprofit organizations, hundreds of retirees who want to give back, and it's just very fulfilling. I feel like I've had a good life.
All right, my name is Andy Lord. I'm the Senior Director of Admissions with the University of Florida's MBA program. My positive message to you would be come back to school, invest in yourself. Education is one of the best investments that anybody can make, and I think it could be a life changer.
Hi, I'm Dr. Naz Aaron Gooch. I am the Associate Director of Admissions for our Executive and Professional MBA programs here at the University of Florida, and I just want to thank you all for coming out today and learning more about the Coral Gables Chamber of Commerce.
I don't know.
It's a hard way to say.
Do it again.
I can't.